all did the voting. We voted for him en masse. It is because we love him. We feel happy. That is why we are here, to make the official inauguration.
Wednesday, 29th of May 2019 marks the beginning of another administration in the history of Lagos State. On this day, at the historic ground of Tafabalewa Square on Lagos Island, His Excellency Mr. Babajide Olusola Sanwo-Olu and Dr. Kadri Obafemi Amzat were sworn in as Governor and Deputy Governor of Lagos State, respectively.
Jide Olusola, the Governor. Igbega e konka ajumo se wani ni Lagos State ajumo se wani.
With these, they took the mantle of leadership of a state which stands undisputed as the commercial nerve center of Nigeria for the next 4 years.
Gomina tuntun baba wa Babajide Olusola Sanwo-Olu ati igbakeji won baba wa Kadri Obafemi Amzat nso na niyan won dupe lowo gbogbo apatapata won ni ajo se ni igbega ipinle Eko ajumo se ni.
In his inaugural speech titled Awakening the Greater Lagos, Governor Sanwo-Olu assured Lagosians of his commitment towards the cause of making the center of excellence the toast of the nation. He expressed his readiness to build upon the achievements of Asiwa Ajubola Ahmed Tinubu and other predecessors.
I stand here today as your governor. This day marks the beginning of a new chapter in our journey to greatness. Today, I ask you to join me on this journey to awaken a greater Lagos. When we speak of a greater Lagos, we speak not of empty words. It is a deep and profound assertion we mean. We intend to take and make history by making ourselves and our children a better future. Therefore, on this day, on this precious land we call our home, let us stand together in this very place of history. Let us vow to ourselves and to prosperity that we shall not just dream of a greater Lagos. Let us agree this day that we shall collectively rise up to build a Lagos of our dream. Asiwaju led the team that created the blueprint for the progressive development. Both himself and Babatunde Raji Fashola's administration faithfully executed that economic blueprint and established the structures and institutions of progressive governance in that process. My predecessor, the former governor of Lagos State, Governor Akinwumi Ambode, pushed forward in a special manner. His efforts and his action shall be duly remembered.
He urged Lagosians to support the cause of making the state a place of pride.
I speak to those who trace their earliest ancestral back to this land and to those who come just last week. I speak to the poor and to the rich. I speak to the Danfo driver that is at CMS station. I speak also to the millionaire that is in Ikeja. I speak to the food vendor that is at my 12 market. I speak as much to the real estate titan that lives in Lekki. I speak to the employer that is in Badagry. I speak to the employee that is in Ikorodu. I speak to that teacher in Alimosho. And I speak to that student in Lasu. I speak to our mothers and our fathers. I speak to the civil servant in Alausa. And I speak to our public sector and our private sector. We are all Lagosians. I say to you all, let us explore how we can best establish an harmony of interest and avoid the glory tendency to focus on those things that divide are differentiators.
As the 15th governor of the state, he articulated the 6th developmental framework with the acronym FIMS, which is carefully designed to enhance development in the state.
The framework of our 6 pillars of development agenda, which is called the themes, which I will mention as traffic management and transportation, health and environment, education and technology, making Lagos the 21st century economy, entertainment and tourism, and finally, security and governance. We will make and create the right environment in which security of life and property are guaranteed. In our ultimate goal will be to ensure that Lagos State remains the top destination for the continent for us to live, to work, and to invest. These 6 pillars of development represent the response of the yearnings of our people. They constitute the foundation that must be restored for our future.
Community stakeholders who came to show their support to the new government say they believe it's a step in the right direction to reposition the state.
As community leaders, we are excited. As community development practitioners, ours is to support all governments in all government that is in power, so that dividend of democracy will get to the nook and crannies of all our communities in Lagos State.
Well, as a community, and being the head of the community, we feel elated. And the reason is that Lagos is known for as the center of excellence, and in terms of governance, they have been performing very well. So I don't expect anything less from Babatunde Sanwo-Olu. So being a new governor, he knows the challenges ahead, he knows what he met on the ground, and I hope that openly he would like to improve on what he met on ground rather than coming down from that standard.
I feel elated because seeing that the duel of Sanwo-Olu and Hamzat coming in as the governor and deputy governor, these are two tested people that we know will deliver at any point in time because of the experience they've gotten within the system. So we are happy that we have this set of people coming in at this point in time.
A positive transition from one governor to another, and it means a new progress from the previous one to a new one, a new development from the previous one to a new one. So we are expecting that the emergence of this new governor will usher in development in Lagos State, other development, progress, and peace.
While felicitating with the governor and his deputy on their assumption of duty, they expressed their expectation from this administration.
I felt so happy, and I am also happy for the Gosha for having the duo of the governor and deputy. They are well experienced. I have no doubt in my mind that they will take the Gosha to great heights. Don't forget the two men who are part of the team of Olatunibu and also BRF. I want to assure you, they will see wonders in Lagos, they will continue the good job and take us to great heights.
I'm very happy and delighted, and I know it's God's doing, and it is marvelous in my sight. We expect governor to take us to next level, and we believe he will deliver. He will deliver by giving us new structures in the community, help all the community, the development association, to build their abandoned projects.
I am looking forward to more progress in Lagos State. I am looking forward to more progress in Nigeria. I'm very delighted. I'm very honored to be here today. And we look forward to things to better Nigeria.
We want peace. We want development. Everything good in terms of school, hospital, roads, this, that, and so on and so forth. That is what we want, and we believe it will do it.
The area of security, we have relative peace in Lagos State. But since the primaries, some of the people of Underworld, the Hoodlums, they are taking the stage again. which I would like him to look at critically, because if Lagos is safe, the whole Nigeria is safe. And as a matter of fact, we have been enjoying it before. Whatever project that CDA is doing is a relief to the government, because they cannot go to the nooks and crannies of the state. It is CDA that who does that. So if they do that for us, I think it will be better for us.
We want to see a new government of inclusive, government of the people, government of the community, where development will be taken to the grassroots, where people will be involved in the running of their affairs. I want to congratulate the new governor, Mr. Olusola Sanwo-Olu, and I want to pray that God Almighty will see him through his tenure. I equally congratulate his deputy, Dr. Bafemi Amzat. I wish them best of luck. Now to our community members. We have to cooperate with the new governor to see that development is brought to every corner of Lagos State.